Hola amigos, welcome back to my channel. This is the second part of the cost of living in San Pedro, Guatemala. Before I dive into the cost of living, I would like to show you this free monthly magazine called Atitlan. It's all in English. It has some news of the Lake Atitlan area. This is the December edition. It talks about like how to celebrate the holidays around the lake. Also, there's a secondhand bookstore in San Pedro. The owner passed away in October, unfortunately, and now this wonderful lady called Anita takes over the place. Besides, it has the chicken bus schedule to Guatemala City, Shella in Antigua. You can do a screenshot here if you need to plan your trip. Also, there's a boat schedule to Panajachel and Santiago. However, use it as a reference only and always confirm with the people who work there. For the rest, it's all ads from restaurants, massage places, travel agencies, holistic classes, and different businesses that target tourists. It comes with a map, so it's quite easy to find the place that you want to go. I picked up this copy from the Italian cafe next to my school. I saw many Western restaurants distribute it, so I don't think it's difficult to find. Now let's dive into the cost of living. I will talk about the transportation first. Tuk-tuk is usually 5 to 10 quetzales per ride within the town, which is around 67 cents. If you're going to the neighbor town called San Juan, it's 10 quetzales. The road is extremely bumpy and dusty. During the rainy season, it becomes a river. So don't try to save that 10 quetzales and walk. You can also take a boat to go there with the same price. In San Juan, there are lots of women cooperative organizations. They grow cotton at their backyard, color it with natural ingredients, and make outfits, scarf, and everything. It's very beautiful. Besides, some have their little garden to grow herbal tea. I bought a sage tea for my toothache. The aroma is much stronger than those commercial ones. It really helped me to calm down my pain a little. For both, the price for foreigners and locals are different. It's official, it's not a scam. Going to Panajachel, which is the biggest town at the lake area, is 25 quetzales per way. That's around $3.26. Over there, you can find stores for frozen meat as well as a supermarket. Another town is called San Marcos, which is a very popular yoga, meditation, holistic area. The boat is 10 quetzales each way. There's no food market in San Marcos, but you will find a few stores for vegetables. Going to Santiago is 100 quetzales for a return ticket, which is around $13 per foreigner. That's quite expensive. Last time I went with my teacher and she negotiated to 75 quetzales for both of us. Besides, we depart from a different pier. For Santa Cruz, I've never been there because I think there's nothing to see. However, in my perception, it's a place for people with more affordability and would like to stay away from the crowd. If you come to San Pedro from Antigua, the shuttle is around $23 per person, depending on the vehicle and the agency. Shuttle means a van for 15 passengers. Those are private vehicles from travel agencies and they have a fixed schedule. If you are lucky, the whole trip is around 4 hours. For the shuttle, it's quite crowded and they will put your stuff on top of the car. So when it rains, your stuff will get quite moist, even they put a cover on top. If you take a private taxi, it's ranging from $65. It's more comfortable than a shuttle. If you have two or more people and you do not have too many belongings, it's worth it. Just ask your school or your host to arrange it for you. If you don't need to visit Antigua, you can depart from the airport, but I think you need to pay more because the route is longer. If you need to go to the airport, usually you need to transfer to another shuttle. And between both shuttles, you need to wait around 1 hour or 1.5 hours. If you are leaving from San Pedro to catch a morning flight in the city, I strongly suggest you to stay in Antigua for the night. Two students from my school booked their taxi early in the morning, but somehow there was a conflict between the tuk-tuk drivers of San Pedro and San Pablo. The road was blocked, so they missed the flight. It's pretty easy to find a cheap place to stay in Antigua. Just plan ahead. Another way to go to San Pedro from Antigua is taking a shuttle to Panajachel first, then take a boat. The shuttle to Panajachel is 2.5 hours for $15. The boat is 30 minutes for $3.26, as mentioned earlier. It seems to be faster, but both of the piers are not very well built. It's very difficult if you have heavy luggage. I was so thankful that people from my shuttle were helping me, otherwise I won't be able to do it. For the month, I spent $55 on transportation. For tours, I only went to Chichicastenango, which is a very interesting town, and a hiking trip to San Juan with a tour guide. That's not fun because he took a very boring route. For the month, I spent $23. Next is personal care. I spent $35. I spent 100 quetzales on gym membership. So far, I found two gyms in San Pedro. Both of them do not have a treadmill but spinning bike. Weight training machines are very broken and rusty, so I just use the dumbbells. Toilet paper because the toilet paper in my place is so thin and I had allergy of it. One single roll costs 450 quetzales and a bag of four rolls is 7 quetzales. For cell phone, I just top up my 5GB plan at $13. Accommodation. I had the cheapest rent ever in my 1 year trip. It was referred by my school. It's a house with four rooms. Each room has its own bathroom, a very spacious bedroom area. The kitchen is shared. It's only $250 a month. I can walk to my school in 3 minutes. That's wonderful. The downside is that it has too many cats. There are 10 cats. It's quite annoying. In the daytime, they just beg for food all the time. And the structure of the place doesn't have indoor living room, so people won't hang out and chat. Since San Pedro is already very boring, it's quite depressing that you don't have a human being to talk to. Normally, I like to get a room from Airbnb and live with the host. But in San Pedro, it's quite difficult to find or it's very expensive. The place I'm living now is on the top floor of my landlord's house. It's my own apartment. It costs $25 per night. For those who has a bigger house, they are running homestay for students. So they will have extra income and people won't mess up the kitchen. If you're going to work online, please check the internet speed with your host. Well, it's fine to go on social media, but uploading a video, it may take a day. The internet speed in the cafe is more or less the same. Fortunately, the Wi-Fi in this place is pretty fast, so I'm able to upload more videos this month. Most of the properties do not have a washing machine. If you need to do laundry, you need to spend extra money on that. For Spanish school, I spent $567 for 21 private classes. Each class is around 4 hours. There's so many Spanish school in San Pedro, and you can definitely find a cheaper one. I met a girl in a cafe one day, and she said she only paid $100 per week. No, actually less than $100 a week. But I have my reason. I'm not gonna explain it in here. It will be in my other video. Last is miscellaneous, it's $24. For the whole month, I spent $1,308. If you just want to hang out here, share an accommodation with your partner, and no need to go to school, $500 to $600 per month per person should be enough. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe, and share this video. Until next time, bye!